was me playing some guitar for you guys before I tell you how I was almost possessed. So what I experienced was, what was told to me was that I experienced demonic oppression. When I was 12, my grandmother was like, "You're going to church camp." I was like, "No, I'm not." And I went to church camp and I actually loved it. I'm not much of a religious person, but what I saw there was not religious at all. Like, it was a very spiritual place, and they were doing healings, and I was watching it happen. Come on now. That was my cat. So we were walking back to the cabin, and I was totally fine, and then I stepped in the cabin, and I was hit with this wave of depression. Like, I was like, holy crap. Like, it was like... like that, like so noticeable that I was like, what happened to me? And I was telling the girl, I was like, I don't know what just happened to me, but I don't feel right. And I just feel really depressed right now. And then all of a sudden I got really angry and I was like, I'm not bipolar. I have mental illnesses, but at this point of my life, I would say that I wasn't really dealing with any of these things right now. Like, I had always been depressed to a certain level, but most of these things definitely came within the last 2 years. So I've kind of felt like I was stable. You know what I'm saying? I just got mad, and then I kept hearing like something in my head saying like, drown yourself in the lake, you're a whore, nobody wants you here. Like, all this kind of stuff. I'm like, even though it's coming from my head, I'm like, that's not me. I found myself going to the lake where we have like a huge lake in the church camp, and I'll probably just post a picture of that. So basically, I went over there, and this kid, his name is, we call him Cracker, not like any racial, well, I don't know if it is, but that's how he introduced himself to me, and I love him. So he was there and I just ended up yelling at him. Like, I don't even remember about what. During this time, it was just like a blur. And I was just like, I don't want to be here. I want to drown myself in this lake. And he's younger than me, so I would not tell him this. Like, I would not do that. I don't know, things just started getting weirder. Like, I would go in for sermons and I would just feel like really disgusted, and like I would be like, oh, they're just here for the money, they're just here for the money, and these people are hypocrites, and like, God's not real, this is all fake. And I get like infuriated to the point where I had to excuse myself out of the sermon. I was like, I don't want to hear this shit. Like, I was like belligerent. I was like, I don't want to hear this bullshit. I was like, what the hell? And then I sat down and I could feel something heavy on my back clawing into me. And if you put your hand on my back, you could feel like something moving my skin. And then I felt like a pressure on my head. So like, you know those exorcism movies where their heads are like that, and just, my head was going like that, but not because of whatever they make it seem like in the movie, but because it felt like something was pushing on my head like that. Like, and my head, like my neck was suddenly like very like thin, balancing my heavy head, and it's just going in a circle. And I feel like myself going off the chair, and I'm like, you guys need to pray on me right now, because this is not me, this is not who I am. They prayed on me, and I felt my eyes like roll back up into my head, and I just wanted them to stop for some reason. I was like, oh my god, I don't know what to do. So I went up to this woman and I asked her if she noticed anything different about me. That's just all I asked. Like, I could have been asking like how I look or anything. She was like, do you want me to be honest with you? I was like, well, of course I want you to be honest with me. She's like, there is a demon on your back, and she stays by your bed and watches you, and her name is Lilith. I'm like, why wouldn't you tell me this? Like, I didn't ask for some reason. I was just like, good to know, gotcha. Hey, so basically my camera shut off before I got to finish, but All that really happened after is this Todd White guy, and you can totally look him up, he's awesome. I went up to him and I told him what was going on with me, and he laid hands on me and said a whole lot of stuff, like I don't really remember. After that, I just felt like something leave my body. So I didn't really have like a full like possession, thank God, but I definitely had moments where I felt like something was on me and controlling me. And if I didn't take care of it, it could have turned into a possession. So that's really the main point. So I hope that you enjoyed this, and I'm like falling asleep as I'm recording this, but I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope that it gave you some entertainment. I don't know.